Thank you for watching me play. How are you, everybody? How are you today? Today, per request, I am going to do a little tutorial. It's really difficult to say. Tutorial for crow and hi, side crow and titi basna. Yes, I thought it's the lady wants to know about the transition, but I guess not. Hi Mari-chan, how are you? So, well, let's see, crow pose, 4 a.m. oh my god. Okay, crow pose is like kind of hard, you know. Side crow is much easier, I think, don't you think? Mari, do you think side crow is more easier than regular crow? What do you think? Hi Gretchen, how are you? Yes, the lady said she wants to improve her crow and her side crow and titi basna by Christmas. Good to see you. Yes, by Christmas. So means she has September, October, November, and December. So 4 months. 4 months. So I told her for the titi basna, you need to have stretchy hamstrings, so you know, forward hold, you know, a lot. But crow, you know, we can try. Okay, so let's see, let's check it out. Okay, let's see. So side crow is much easier for me, I said, because, okay, here, let's see. Crow is kind of like, you know, it's really scary because a lot of people think, you know, if I'm gonna boom, you know, I'm gonna hit my face or something like that, you know, like, well, it's okay. If you hit your face, you know, mess up your teeth and everything, you have a chance to get better teeth and better face. Think about that, okay? So anyway, yes, I mean, if you really feel like it's really scary, you know, why don't you put block right here? Yeah? Block right here. Then I would suggest, you know, put your knee underarm, you know, right there, and lean forward, okay? You don't have to do anything, just lean forward. And why don't you put your forehead here? It's really like, oh, it's a crow already. Yeah, you can kind of feel, you know. So, you know, if you are really scary about that, that's kind of option, you know, and you're not gonna fall. So anyway, the regular crow, I usually do just lean forward, and you can just put the one leg or something, you know, like one leg each. You know, then lean forward, then you have to put your core kicking. My back is kicked in now. I'm using my core. So I don't feel a lot of weight on my arm. My core is working like crazy. Yeah? Okay, so this is crow, but if you can put the arms, you know, mine is a little bit bent, but you know, straight, you can do this way too, you know, like hug, you know, really tight, like a baby crow, really squeeze using the knees, and baby crow. Hi, Eric-kun. Ne? Baby crow. I'm squeezing my knee. That's another way to get in. And like I said, side crow is much more easier because, okay, here, you're just doing this. And hand have to be on the mat, leg have to be up. So, twist, 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 twist. You have to twist really, really on your leg. I just ate. So this is not the easy pose for me. But then twist, you can put both elbow on your side too. But I would do just one elbow. But you can put two. Then just lean. Just lean. Lean. See? Same thing. But you have to activate all your muscle. You're not gonna be like this in the air. It's scary. It's scary. Yes. You have to be hyping. You have to activate all the muscle. You don't wanna be, okay? So I would say twist, 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 twist. I'm sweating already. All the twist. Twist, twist, twist. Okay? And I use only one elbow. But you can put two elbows on your thighs. Thigh and hip. But, okay, here. Then, just lean. Just lean. Just lean. Just lean. Just lean. Just lean. I'm sweating already though. Okay, here, the other side. Twist, twist, twist. Really twist. Really twist. And lean. Okay, I'm gonna use both my elbows this time. Lean. Sounds different. So that's side crawl. And to me, side crawl is much easier. Because pink. I just did this pink. I mean, you don't wanna hit your face and mess up your face. So why don't you just, this is good for maybe Ash. Why don't you put the blocks in here, you know, in front already? Your head is already on there. Yeah. And you can just get up, maybe. And if you don't want to get up, you can just be there. But you're still using your core. Yeah, hip is kind of high, but you know. This way is good. And I also said, if you hit your face, mess up your face, teeth, you have a chance to get better face, better teeth, so don't worry about it, okay? Okay, so Titi Basna. Okay, she wants to do, she said, Titi Basna by Christmas. By Christmas. Yeah, better face. Gretchen. Can you imagine? Better face of Gretchen? Oh my God. Oh my God. Okay, so anyway. So I told her to do Titi Basna, you need stretchy hamstring. Because remember Pink? Titi Basna is not like this. Titi Basna is more like this. Remember? On your shoulder. Huh. So let's see. To set up. On your shoulder. Huh? You get in. Get in, get in, get in. Put your both legs on your shoulder, then just sit down. Hey, sit down. Then leg is gonna be straight, like a Japanese gymnastic Olympic gym. Japanese gymnastic Olympic team. Then straight, really straight. If your hamstring is tight, it's gonna be like this. Yeah? If your hamstring is tight, it's gonna be spider. Okay? So so you might wanna practice like this, because eventually your legs, because it's really hard. If you can put your legs on the shoulder, it's really tough because you have to do this way. But it's really tough. You know? Well, so the setup is the key. The setup. That's you? Okay. Yeah. Well, I used to be like that. Then I just watch all the great yogis, you know, picture. What's wrong with my picture? You know, and then I realized, like, hamstrings. Hamstrings. So the setup is really important. Just put your shoulder underneath. Then sit down and stretch your legs. And from here to Bakasana. From here to Bakasana, it's kind of like a difficult. Not difficult. I mean, different transition. But you have to go really slow. Yes, I have hamstring issues. I have hamstring issues. Yeah, I couldn't do Tittivasana. I would say maybe like it took me like 1 year. Yep. It took me 1 year to, you know, stretch. And then today, Pink, you're laughing, but that was no joke. See, I was trying to put this leg a little bit down and down and down. Like this, down and down. Like this, down and down. And I was gonna put my underarm there. So that's why I was using straps. You said I don't need a strap, but I need one for this. Yes, I was gonna put my shoulder over. See, that's why. So I'm gonna start to do this. This is really, really hard. Yeah. Yes, that one. And I need an assistant, somebody, to do this, you know? Yeah. Somebody can be just, you know, on my back. Then maybe I could just do this. Yeah. So anyway, any questions? I'm sweating already today. I just tried jump back practice. I couldn't jump back. See? I couldn't jump back, huh? Straight arm. It's kind of difficult because, see, my arm is kind of already, hyper extension. But I'll try. Yes, more core, then back to, and not hip high. Not hip too high. Yeah, just lean. Okay, here. I'm gonna watch myself. Just lean. Let's see, lean. And feet up. And my core kicking. Well, I think this is something to do with wrist flexibility. Yeah, like this. Wrist flexibility. Yeah. Yeah, I'm watching a comment. Yeah, this too, I mean, like, because this have to go this way. Yeah, see, if your hip is too high, you're totally using different muscle, I think. I used to be like that, though. I used to be like, put my hip high like this, you know, really high, like that. Yeah, if your hip is really high, it's kind of difficult to put arm straight. Yeah. So hip kind of low. Yeah. And just lean against, I think. Lean. Yes, I think. Okay, let's check it out if I can do jump back. Today I couldn't. Yeah.
I couldn't.
Trish jumped back from crow. It's like, it's just breathing. Okay? You know? Blow the candle. Yeah, blow the candle on your birthday cake. Okay? So, when you are doing bakasana, and you're breathing, right? And inhale, exhale, you jump back, okay? Inhale, exhale, jump back. Yeah. Take, and jump back. You just have to tell your legs, like, jump back. You know, then the breathing technique is very, very important. Yeah, I don't think I can jump back if I don't, you know, use breathing technique. Yeah, just do. Yes, yes, that's good. That's good, Pink. Yes, yes. Okay, let's check it out. Breathing and then jump back is same thing. See? Like a Janyasasana. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then 1, 2, 3, 4. Then 1, 2, 3, 4. You know, four count. And then 1, 2, 3. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4. Pick it up. Exhale, 1, 2, 3, 4. Jump back. Yeah, I always count that way. Yeah, four count. So, last inhale, I pick up. Yep, and exhale. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, so I hope. I've been practicing Ashtanga from January 29th, 2015, and other yoga. I started to do regular yoga. I started to practice regular yoga on March 1st, 2013. Yes. So like 3 years. Altogether 3 years. Yes. Ah, hi! Hi, Tanisha! I'm sweating like a pig. Sweating like a pig. Today is my day off. My day off. I ate a lot for lunch. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Wow, man. Hot, hot, hot. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. Hot, hot, hot. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ashtangi. Ashtangi is having day off. Yes. Oh, oh, by the way, Pink, I have something for you. Yesterday, I found, I just told you about the jump back, new information. I use index finger knuckle to push, but also, after that, I use here. So, my weight is going to be shifted and jump back. So, here too, here pushing, really hard. So like my hands are like handstand hands, like grips, not just completely flat, grips. Then I'm using my head, you know, balance. So I kind of realize when I'm doing a jump back really slow, really long one. I'm using my finger to balance. Let's see if I could do long one. Watch my hands. Right here, push. Man, my hands are like, yeah, my hands are like Like this. My hands are like this. Hola. Come on. My hands are like this. And yeah, kind of like this. Not completely flat. You're like a handstand hand. And I'm pushing using my index finger knuckle and right here, this one. Can you see that? This one. Here. Around here. Like this. So more I can push. So my more I, you know, my butt goes high. Make sense? Because if I don't push, my butt is not gonna be high. If I don't push. I mean, see, look at this. So, okay, I'm not gonna jump back, but look at this. Like, basically, it's just this push, then going down. So, while I'm in the air, I'm pushing more to jump back. More, pushing more, jump back. So if I don't jump back, you can clearly see my butt is going down. You know what I mean? Gravity. Push. And gravity, yeah. You know? But more, push, and jump back. Then I'm using my head going down. Yeah. So to me, fast push is very, very important. Fast little push and just squeeze all the muscle. Hang in there. Jump back. So it's hang in there. That's really important. Yeah, that's a chaturanga, like this. Hang in there, jump back. So, yeah, really. And then I found out music helps. Music. If you kind of like fun, you know, you can do more music. What's the good music? This is good. Okay. I hope there's no advertising. Vegan diet. Oh, vegan diet is really working, really. I mean, for my tummy, really. Vegan diet. Advertising, yeah. Okay, here. This music works. So maybe it's good with music. Okay? So, all right, so anyway, thank you for watching. Okay. Thank you for watching. Thank you, everybody. All right. No question? Okay, good. Good, no question. So hopefully the lady is gonna see it. Music is helpful, really. Okay? All right. Bye. Have a great day, everybody. Bye-bye.